Hi friends, I'm Piali, organizer of Discus Agile Network, a Scrum Alliance user group sponsored by Eisenbridge Consultancy Private Limited. Today, I'm very excited to share a very good news with all of you. We have scheduled our annual conference for Discus Agile Network on December 15th and 16th this year in Bangalore. We have multiple themes. We are trying to conduct an multi-theme conference. The themes are personal agility, Kanban, hybrid agile, and coaching and leadership. And the theme owner for personal agility is Peter Stevens, who is now present with me. Peter is a CST from Switzerland. And now I would request Peter to tell us something more about himself.
Oh, well, thank you, Piali. First of all, I'd like to thank you, Saket, and of course, the Discus Agile Network for the opportunity to join you in Bengaluru this December. It's an honor to have a track focused around the topic of personal agility. As you know, my day job is I'm a Scrum trainer. I teach people that their lives can be better, that their work can be better and more fun than it is now, and they'll be more effective while they do it. And I've kind of gotten into that topic as a way to organize my own life, and that's taken me in some very interesting directions. So I've been working on a book on this for the better part of a year. And so I'm excited that the topic of personal agility, kind of with a small p, is this going to be the center of the theme at the Discus Agile conference.
Great. Being the theme owner of the personal agility framework, would you please tell us in detail about the theme, about the personal agility framework?
Sure. Well, I think that the big question or the open question is agility relevant to our whole lives, or is it just something for the workplace? If I paraphrase the Agile Manifesto, they would say, we are uncovering better ways of living our lives by doing it and by helping others to do the same. Now, officially, when we talk about Agile, people think about developing software in a team context to produce better stuff for customers or maybe make more money for our stakeholders. But the shift that we make when we start becoming agile is more about the mindset, the values, and the attitudes. So how does agility apply to our own lives? Now, your personal vision might include things about your family or your community, spirituality, finances, lifestyle, perhaps even the desire to have some slack time at the end of the day. Some people set a course, others just go with the flow. So what this theme is about is exploring how people could apply agility to their own lives, but also how they're actually doing it.
So what kind of talk submission you are looking for from the speakers?
Okay, well, what we're looking for are people who have been applying the values and principles of agility to their own lives. How do you help others to do the same, to be more agile in how you live? What benefit has it brought you? Or maybe it hasn't brought benefit. Maybe something has changed, maybe not. So what we'd like to explore is how people are applying agility to their own lives. We're looking for submissions in which people share their approaches, their experiences, their successes, and their failures in applying agile values and principles in the context of their life.
Okay. And what about you? Are you going to submit any talk for the conference?
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely. What got me started on what I now call personal agility was the realization that I had more things to do than I had time to do them in. And so part of the problem was, if I can't do everything, I want to pick stuff that matters. And how do you pick stuff that matters? And that's really the hard question. So my talk is going to, at one level, it's going to talk about how to do more of what matters. But at the same time, when you look at the challenges that companies have to become agile, I've discovered that the challenges that companies have and the challenges that individuals have are very similar. So what I want to do is connect the dots between doing more that matters in your personal context with having organizations that are being more effective. So it's going to be both about the personal side, developing yourself, and then connecting it to work so you have more impact at work.
The most interesting thing I found here is do what matters most mm-hmm. for you.
Yes.
Because it's a thing most of us struggle with. We have a lot of things to do and we have very limited time to do mm-hmm. To finish all the works.
Yes, and no shortage of bosses and no shortage of things to do.
Yes.
Yes.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Yes. So I'm sure we are going to have a lot of talks on this topic, this theme. And yes, would you like to add anything more on this?
Okay. Well, what I'd like to say is I'm just really excited about the event in general. There are a couple of other very interesting themes, also from Kanban to coaching and professional development. And so I think that this is, this is going to be really a great event with some interesting and valuable exchanges of information. And did I mention I'm going to do a workshop on personal agility too? You'll be able to find out how to do it. So I'm looking for, I just think there's going to be a lot of interesting stuff happening, and I'm looking forward to coming and meeting people there, meeting you there.
So yes, let's have we are also looking forward to meet you and Maria in the conference, and yes, looking forward to the personal agility workshop. I'm sure we are going to learn a lot of new things, a lot of new insights to manage our work and life in the personal agility workshop. Thank you, Peter. Thank you for sharing about personal agility framework here. And thanks, friends. And we are looking forward to meet many of you in the conference on December 15th and 16th in Bangalore. Thank you.
See you in December.